थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू। या वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू अवर डिस्टिंग्विश गेस्ट मिस्टर डॉक्टर श्रीनिवासन अय्यंगार सर एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट। I welcome all of you for today's second session on pedagogical approaches in higher education. I take this privilege to introduce today's distinguished speaker for this session, Mr. Dr. Srinivasan R. Iyengar. Sir is working as an associate professor in the area of strategic management and marketing at Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies, Department of Management Studies, Mumbai University. Sir is also contributed to the reputed institute like IIM Indore and Sambalpur as a visiting faculty. Sir holds PhD degree from the Mumbai University. Sir's areas of interest are strategic management, international business, and retail shoppers' behavior. Sir has more than 2 decades of experience in corporates and academics. Sir is an approved PhD guide from Mumbai University in the field of management. Sir is guiding more than a dozen of PhD students currently. Sir is also working as a member on the advisory board of Journal of Business Retail and Marketing Business Management. Apart from that, the Journal of Development Research, in that board also sir is working. Sir has a great wide experience as an editor-in-chief of Journal of Indian Retail. Sir has received few awards for his recognitions in the field of academic excellence from Higher Education Forum also. Sir has received Rajiv Gandhi Award from Indian Solidarity Council for his contribution to the higher education and in the field of management. Sir also has an authored few books, few to name those are like Mall Management, Strategic Retail Management and Cases in Retail Management. Sir has also had a wide experience as a consultant to few organizations in the area of strategy development as an independent director. And we congratulate sir also in this month, in the beginning of this new year, sir has published a new book on case studies published by an Himalaya publication house. So we congratulate you, sir, that in the beginning of the year, your book has come out in the market for the researcher and the people working in the field of strategic management. So on behalf of Cyber, on behalf of all the participants, I welcome for today's particular session. I just would like to remind you all the participants that we'll have a 75 minutes presentations, interactive session with the sir, and then we'll have a question answer session. So I request Srinivasan sir to take a charge of the session. Over to you, Srinivasan sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the very brief and very wide introduction. And I really thank Dr. Kale sir for inviting me for this session. Probably this will be my last COVID time. I have done more than 8 to 10 workshops on FDP on case writing. So it's my pleasure to interact all. Almost it's close to 197 participants. I hope everybody are academicians. Right. I request everyone, if you have any question, what type of session are you interacting? Because, you know, my challenge is I have done this workshop. The book, sir, what mentioning is an outcome of FDP at Jamnalal Bajaj. I also done one more FDP at IIM Indore on case writing. Today, I'm going to give combination of what is case, right? What are the benefits of discussing case? How to write case? How to write teaching notes? This is what I used to do for 5 full day workshop. But here I have a limitation. Everything I have to share it in matter of 90 minutes. In fact, not even 90 minutes, it's 75 minutes, right? So my request is, I request all the faculty member, what type of lectures are you keen? Whether you'd like to be in listening mode or you'd like to have a question answer interactive mode, your absolutely options are open to us. I really wish to customize the way what you expect, right? So any suggestion from participants, faculties?
Sir, interactive session. Now,
fantastic, pleasure, right? So because I respect all the faculty members, we are all, most of them are academicians, I believe, right? This is a case study. According to you, it's what you, how many people you do? In fact, I have done one more case now. Maybe within a week, I can able to share it. The case study might publish in Harvard Business School, Richard Ivey also, regarding Facebook investing in Jio for 10%, less than 10% stake for 45,000 crores. In fact, I still remember when I was writing my first Facebook in 2009, case study in retail management. And that was my first book. I made an attempt. And I used to write all caselets. So today I'm going to give tips, you know, every faculty, how to start writing a case. Before that, I'll give what is introduction to case, right? End of the day, the workshop success is, even if you could able to publish some two-page short cases, I'll be more happy, right? So we try to discuss all this stuff. In fact, I request everyone, whatever question you have, you can please stop in midway, because I don't use intentionally PPTs. I don't use PPT ever, right? But if you want to share any information, I will share it to you through LinkedIn or email to the sir. Probably you can get all the contents, whatever you like it, right? Because writing case, one stage. But before get into that, what is case study? Anybody can share anything. I wish to hear from you. I hope you must be teaching cases in your classroom, teaching pedagogy also, right? Case study is only a teaching tool. It's a pedagogy, right? So what is case study?
Sir, in case study, the problems are there. Students have to find out the solution to a particular problem. And the solution should
Fantastic.
Be
like
Sir, it is an issue.
Fantastic.
So your intent to study Fantastic. Thoroughly and find some solution for that.
Fantastic. Amazing. Anything? Any other than that?
Hello, sir. Good morning.
So good morning.
As far as my understanding is, case study is a situation analysis. This is what I have understood Fantastic. Throughout. Thank you so much, sir.
Fantastic. I would like to conclude whoever said three statements. I'll try to merge it and tell you what you have said. I'm not going to give my own definition. The definition, what you shared, your understanding, I'll try to bring the answer, right? Case study is a written description. Normally, case studies is a written description of a particular problem or, madam also said, right, situation. It could be a problem or situation requiring analysis and decision. Again, I'll repeat, case study is a written description of a problem or situation requiring analysis and decision. This is what case study. Before that, I'll tell you what is that, you know, our MBA education is all about, right? Our MBA education, normally our education system focusing on more and more on learning and doing. We learn by doing. Normally, we try to teach to the students the skill set which is required in MBA education for the corporate, you know, skill set which is required. And mainly we focus on how to do, right? We normally focus in business school teaching pedagogy, how to do. But if you see what to do and why to do, it's purely missing in academia. Would you like to share the comment on this? The thing what I said? Anyone?
Hello, sir. This is Priyanka Kumari. Sir, yes. It basically means that the objective, why we are doing it, that should be clear to the students. So that clarity has to be there. Whatever
That's
work there.
Absolutely. That is the purpose. What to do and why to do. That is a classic thing we can do through cases. For an example, if you ask case studies, it is only a teaching pedagogy. It is only a tool like a OHP, like a PowerPoint to discuss the concept into application, right? We use case studies. For an example, if you see the pioneer business school in the world is Harvard Business School, which is started in 1906. Very old business school in the world is Harvard School of Business. Harvard is basically a law business. If you see, Harvard is not a management, because management himself is came in the last recent era. The way strategic management came just 3-4 maybe 30-40 years before. Earlier, this subject is about business policy. Now it has become strategic management. Same like the MBA degree himself came 100 years before. Otherwise, earlier, there is no business education all about. When they started the business school, Harvard is basically meant for law. They also have a hospital. It's a very big university. For example, in India, if I say IIT, 99% people say IIT is based for engineering, correct? IIT meant for engineering. But they also have the program, MBA program for SOM in Bombay. Kharagpur, as you know, Vinod Gupta. They also have a management program. They way IIM Ahmedabad also have agri program. But there is a one program is normally positioned to the outside, the B school which is meant for. So Harvard is basically a law school. When they started a business management program, they took all the faculty of law. Is there any lawyers in this crowd? Participants? Almost 105. Anybody teaches law subject or anybody is having lawyer background? Anybody teaching business law, any subjects here in your classroom session? Nobody? Anyone? Okay. So normally if you see lawyer, or anybody's father or husband or wife is working as a lawyer?
Sir, there is one faculty, Mr. Dr. Kiran Kakde, he is teaching business law. In chat box, he has given his comment.
Okay, Kiran Kakde, okay, I couldn't able to see. Okay, Kiran sir, when you teach law, what you do, sir? Normally, how do you teach? You are teaching pedagogy. Is it same like other faculty or how do you do?
Dr. Kiran. Yes, sir, my voice is audible, sir.
Comfortable, yeah. Please go ahead.
Yeah, I'm a management cum law graduate. I'm completed my MBA in HR, PhD and LLB. So while teaching any law subject, whether it is related to the labor law or it's related to a pure law subject, the totally pedagogy is a case-based approach. So we need to take the case laws.
What is case laws?
Yeah, case laws is nothing but some historical description. Okay, historical description which is actually happened. Okay, through which we analyze it. Yeah.
Go ahead. I'm happy the way you are proceeding. Please.
Yeah. So it's an historical description which is actually happened. Okay. So to analyze that, we just try to check it out how we can implement it in a futuristic base.
Fantastic. So when you want to argue or when you want to teach something, you try to quote from the past incidents or past cases which has happened, and you want to do it present today. Even if you see the lawyers, when they argue for the cases, when they want to argue their particular case, they always try to quote relevant to the case which happened earlier, and they want better judgment, better than past. Am I right?
Yes, sir. It's true.
That is the beauty of case studies. So what happened? Cases are real life situation. Then you will get a question. Sir, sometimes the cases can be hypothetical. Absolutely, that is also possible. So first we discuss what is case, right? Second, we are going to discuss about and what are the benefits of discussing case study in the classroom session, right? For example, why should I discuss case? Anyway, I'm teaching well, my students love the lecture, they are rating me best faculty I am. But why should I use case study to teach in the classroom? Why faculty will benefit? Do they faculty benefit or students also will benefit or both the people will benefit of discussing case study in the classroom? For an example, I'll tell you from the student's perspective, what are the benefits of discussing case studies, right? Cases are real life situation will already happen. Especially in business school, what happened? I'm telling you, very interesting to write one cases. Earlier, I think it is a few days. Writing a research paper is much more challenging. But now I'm writing more extensive cases. Now I realize that writing cases is much more challenging writing a research paper. for developing a quality international case studies, trust me, sometimes it takes me 6 months to 1 year to write just 12 to 15 page case along with teaching notes, right? So today I'm going to give only a flavor of introduction. Maybe if time permits some other time, you can try to build the content based on the content what I give. Writing case is absolutely interesting because cases when you write, there are, I said two types of case. There are many types. If you go to Google, I'm not focusing on that. According to me, only two types. The cases are real life situation. Another one is hypothesis case. The benefit of discussing case, when you are writing an original case or when you are discussing original case in the classroom, people likes it. Students also likes it. You know why? The cases are real in nature. Sometimes we used to mask the case, hypothetical situation. Why? Companies may not allow. Companies doesn't want to share the information. Sometimes they share information, they say, boss, as a company policy, we don't want to share, reveal our names. That time the case became hypothetical in nature. Right? When you discuss the original case, we'll try to attempt the question when you're writing a case, what are the challenges you get? First, we'll discuss the benefit of discussing case. Why should I teach the case studies? How students will benefit? When you discuss the case study in the classroom, students are become protagonist. You know, person, protagonist means the person who plays vital role in a drama or a movie. It's like a hero. The students are learning from others' experience. Please understand that. That is one of the major benefits. Today, they might be the students, especially in business schools. Normally, if you see business schools across the world, people try to do MBA program with experience. They come with the corporate exposure, right? And they are going to work in the corporate. Today, they might start a journey as a management trainee. Fewer down the line, they try to become, you know, into the corporate at a senior level. That time, if the problem arises, they don't need to worry and scared about how to solve the problems. When they are doing business program, business studies at MBA program, those cases are brought to the classroom for the real life situation. When they are a student, when they discuss the case in the classroom, they learn from others' experience. Very, very important. On an average, any idea how many cases are done in IIMs or in Harvard Business School? Any idea during their MBA program? Forget about Harvard. In IIMs, in India, almost there are 20 IIMs. Even day before yesterday, IIM Sambalpur got inaugurated new campus by EPM. Right? How many cases they do during the MBA program? Any idea? Approximately. Or how many cases do you do during your course? Anybody? Prakash Nair, fantastic. Close to 300, fantastic. If they are dealing off credit or full credit course, if there are full credit course, they definitely do 20 cases. If there is an off credit course, they will do almost 10 cases. Entire teaching pedagogy is purely on case-based teaching methods, especially in all leading business schools in India. When we discuss case studies, if there are 10 case studies are brought, for example, if you teach strategic management, example, 20 cases are discussed, that 20 cases come from versatile industry sectors and different topics, because cases are also absolutely focused. Every case has objectives. Please remember that. For example, if you are teaching marketing, interaction marketing case is absolutely different from marketing environment, is different from STP than pricing and promotion, because cases are absolutely focused in nature. And when you are designing a course, the cases, for example, if you are learning 250 to 300 case during MBA program, just imagine how much knowledge students must be acquiring it. If they go for placement interview, they don't need to prepare separately, because whenever they discuss the case, that focuses on multiple sector, could be aviation, pharma, automobile, education. There are cases are written in the multiple dimensions, IT sector, right? IT sectors. When students learn, their knowledge goes, because they are not learning from hypothetical, real cases. If they're discussing why Jet Airways has failed in the classroom, they know who's Jet Airways promoter. They know the history. They know the industry dynamics. They know which are all the market players. They know who are all the market share. They know who is the market leader. Everything brought into the one case studies. And cases are, when you are discussing students, what are the other benefits students has it? One is they became protagonists, they learn from other experience. Is there any other benefit students will get while discussing the case? They learn from practical knowledge into application. That is a much more important, because in MBA, we don't teach theory. Theory, any students can learn, they can understand how theory can be applicable. For example, there is always people used to say, right, when I hear, normally people will forget, because we hear more concern, the data is more today. The possibility of remembering became much more challenging. When I hear, people will forget. When I see, the people will remember a lot. That is a normal thumb rule, right? When I see, I remember. When I do on my own, what will happen? When I do it on my own, I understand better. That is the pulse of the case study. Because students are dwell, knowledge, expertise, experience. They know-how. That's a know-how concept in the case studies. Whenever you go to the classroom, today, see the problem in teaching today. What are the problem do you face when you go to the classroom? Anybody facing today the same class what you are facing than earlier days as a teacher? Is it the same set of teaching what we have done earlier? Or is it teaching pedagogy is changed? Or what is the student's expectation?
Sir, at present, student already purchases lot of knowledge because of different internet sources. So what happens if we just follow the curriculum, they feel like we already know it. So there has to be certain kind of application based so that we can sustain somehow the interest of the student.
Absolutely well said. So how do you encounter this? Today, Google is giving more knowledge than us. If you go to Wikipedia, that gives original information. How do you encounter this? How are you going to face this problem when you go to the classroom? Even today, you go to classroom through Zoom and multiple media. I'm not talking about whether online or offline. How do you make classroom much more interesting than expected by the students?
So like as I'm a design faculty,
very good.
So apart from the theoretical concept, if I'm dealing with any specific topic, then I need to show certain videos related to that. I ask the student to do certain illustration. I divide the class into different groups so that one group can present and rest of the group can give their feedback. So it's not just like I'm dictating and they are listening. It's about creating a setup where each one is learning from each other.
Fantastic. So the major pulse of the teaching method, when you go to the classroom, the pulse of the teaching is you try to, because when you teach the subject, you might be expert on the particular topic. Student may not be knowing it. They must be hearing first time. Right? So when you go to the classroom, because when you teach the subject, you must be teaching for many years together. So what are the problems you face first? When students should learn, unlearn things. They should learn, unlearn things. That means they should hear unheard things.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, good afternoon. Madam. This is Nazia Ansari. I would like to just add one more point to Priyanka, ma'am. As she said regarding this, like the students, they become more interactive. So just 2 days back, I was taking CSR and one student spoke about that the COVID vaccination, now it has to be included as a part of CSR. So the companies, those who are vaccinating their employees, it could be termed as a part of CSR. And the students, they started to debate on this, whether it should be included or not included. So that was like something which I was also looking forward, but that came as a surprise because they have very different perspectives and they were weighing it with facts and figures. So it was like their interpretation is totally different what we have in the books. So so this is what I wanted to say, sir. Thank you so much.
Madam, in fact, I really appreciate that. You know why? When you go to the classroom, the role of the faculty, especially when you do case studies, that's what I'm coming to the point exactly.
Yes,
the role of the faculty is not a teacher. Please remember that.
Today,
if you go to the students and try to teach, we may not be successful in the classroom. Please remember that.
Yes, sir.
And today, students are acquiring knowledge in multiple ways. And whether knowingly or unknowingly, that WhatsApp University and Google University teaches more than what reality, whether right or wrong, we don't know. Actually, it might be wrong information, it might be fake. I'm not denying that. But still, they come with that knowledge more than what we are expecting. Because when you go to the classroom, we are one faculty, we are going to interact with 50 different minds. It is difficult to bring it together. That's why I used to suggest something when you teach case studies, that major thumb rule is the role of the faculty is not a teacher. Then you will ask them what the faculty should do. Faculty should facilitate.
They should lead
the discussion. For example, as you said, right, when the student said, sir, is the CSR to be done by the company or to the employees, to the public, the faculty role with the experience, they should allow the students to lead the discussion in the right direction.
And it is kind of a mediating role, sir. Yes, absolutely.
For an example, today what happening, ma'am, today if you teach to the student, they may not be appreciating it. What they love, they come with experience, so that they will also see. I'll tell you what are the other benefits of discussing case. And that's what I'm exactly coming to them. Whenever you go to the case study, I said three principles you keep in your mind in a classroom teaching. That means you should teach, I mean, students should learn unlearned things. That means they should learn something which they have not learned before. You try to see what you can able to do value addition than the normal teaching. They should hear unheard things. Whatever you say, they should hear first time, and they should explore unexplored things. As I told you, right, the major thumb rule of discussing case, they should feel experience. They just not hear or listen. They should practice on their own. You try to bring the third quotient in the classroom. Again, I'll repeat. When I hear, I forget. When I see, I remember. When I do on my own, I can understand. That's what exactly case study does.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely.
For an example, that's what I said, right? Our management education is normally focused on, you know, that's what I started with, how to do. Instead of how to do, give more practice to what to do and why to do. That's what the case studies are meant for it. When they discuss the case study in the classroom, they became protagonist. Tomorrow, if they became vice president, if they get the problem, they don't get scared. They don't get panicked. Because that case studies are already practiced in the classroom, and they know if the problem arises, similar problem arises, they know how to solve the case. I'll tell you, when they became a corporate, both were became a classmates. The guy must be working in PNG, this guy must be working in HLN. Same batchmates, dealing same category. I'm giving example. He might be doing Rin Shakti, he must be doing Tide or Surf Excel. Both are same category, same market. Do you think they can able to discuss this problem with the competitor company, even though they are classmates? Is it possible in corporate? Is it possible? Can you discuss with your competitor, even though you are own classmates? So this is the problem, can I? You can't.
Ethically not.
Yes.
Uh-huh. What about ethical? Yes. It is not possible, ego. And company strategy doesn't allow. Yes. Or can you go talk to your boss every time when the problem arises?
No, sir.
That time must be difficult. If you talk to your juniors, that time that ego clashes.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm telling you, that's not what happening today. No, I'm telling you honestly, when I was teaching my IIM Indore batches, the guys who did MBA, again, they are doing second MBA from the corporate, very rich background from VP and CEOs. And we discuss all the cases. They really enjoy the case. They said, why? Sir, this is what the problem happened. We couldn't able to try to discuss it. When I discuss in a classroom, what is the advantage? The same cases are discussed in the classroom. The problem which is faced in the corporate. I'll tell you how I used to do case studies in the classroom. Maybe the second half. Maybe second half means after 10, 15 minutes. What are the other benefits when you're discussing case study in the classroom? Problem is same. One case, one problem is given to the students, but there are 50 different type of students. Assume if we are discussing in Harvard Business School, example, that Harvard Business School attract the students from across from the world, different culture, different religion, different people. In the class, you will find Germans, you'll find Italian, you find Americans, you find Japanese, you find Indians, you find Chinese. Do you think everybody is same? as far as thought process, culture, behavior is concerned?
No, sir, no. So, like, different interpretations could be there for a
right? Yes. Absolutely. The problem is same. But when you are discussing the solution, the versatile experience will come to the class. Probably you will find in India different. When I discuss case study in the premium business school, I get the different community students. Students come from South, Tamilian, Malayalis, Maharashtrians, Marwadi, Guju, Bengalis. Everybody thinks same. You try to give the case study in the classroom. The class will have multiple combinations. Gender-wise, you will have a difference. And community-wise, you will have a difference. But you always find everybody think different. But nobody will say, nene, main kiya, main batai nahi. When they are discussing in a classroom under one roof, there is no cost. There is no financial constraint. They think out of the box thinking if they allow them to discuss. You have to allow them. That's a very important. Lead the discussion. Sometimes we always get complaint. Sir, hamara bachcho log baat hi nahi karte. They are scared of talking. Please, you even if they are comfortable, allow them to talk in the regional language. English is not the main thing. English is required. Because I'm telling you, you allow them to discuss. Sometimes I encounter this problem when I teach in different institutes. Right? I may not get the same response. Whenever I go to some certain institutes, the student doesn't talk. Then I tell them, talk in your own language. You understood the problem or not? If they don't understand the problem, I will explain the problem again. Ask them the solution in their own language. I'm telling you, nothing wrong. In fact, the solutions which come from the students is much, much better. Only thing, faculty has to lead the case.
Yeah.
Allow them to discuss. Very, very important point. While you are discussing case and students, the way they'll come and discuss, sometimes you wonder that answer which has come from. Don't give case before the class. Give the case study 1 week in advance. You know why? How do you discuss case normally in the classroom? Anybody? How do you discuss case study in the class? Because this is a very vast topic. I'm telling honestly, I do 5 days workshop on case studies. The recent workshop is I am Indore. We have done that. How to write a case, how to write a teaching notes, how to teach case study himself require 1 day, minimum 6 hours input. Because teaching case study is an art. It is not just giving a 2-page printout and ask the students to present. That is a one type. I don't say wrong practice. All 5 fingers are not same. But how cases are discussed in the classroom, what are the other benefits of discussing case? One is we discuss protagonist, learning from others' experience. When they discuss the case study under one roof, there is no cost involved. There is no time involved, literally, like a corporate. You ask the problem, students will give, you can't imagine the way they think. Because there is no budget and cost. The same problem can't be discussed in a company because they have a restriction on budget. At least students will think out of the box thinking. Is there any other benefits of discussing case in the classroom teaching?
Sir, from student point of view, they will also be equipped with certain soft skill like communication skill or the body language and other. Because apart from content, that also plays a major role in defining or making them more presentable in a certain group. Ultimately, they have to represent themselves through their knowledge as well as the way they present themselves. So that is also something.
For an example, normally whenever you discuss any concept in the classroom, out of 50 sample, only 10% will keep on talk. That is the normal. Remaining 90% people, they don't talk. If they ask, they will share. There are 10% people never open their mouth at all. Correct? Instead of that, if you discuss case study, entire class into 6 groups. Instead of one leader, there will be a 6 leader coming from the group. If you allow them to do proper preparation, I can tell you honestly, you will come across. Otherwise, you can ask me. I can explain to you later. Normally, we get complaints, sir, hamara bachcho log baat hi nahi karte. Ek bachcho log prepare karke aayega. If you don't allow them to talk, they get, you know, frustration. They want to speak more when they do preparation. So you'll have to give that lead time for the preparation. And you try this and see how the groups, as madam said, right? Definitely, it will help the students to develop leadership skill, communication skill. Very, very important point. You know what is it? listening skill. This also allows the students when to speak, what to speak, which are the things not to be speak. These things can be practiced during classroom session. Is there any other benefits? We already highlighted 6 to 7 advantages of discussing case. Is there any other advantage of discussing case for the faculty?
Sir, it will open a very lateral approach of thinking collectively.
That is correct. Knowledge into application. Fantastic. What else? Is there any benefits of discussing case study in the classroom for the faculty? Will they benefit?
Yes, sir, because the different responses which we will be getting from the student, so that will be also a knowledge addition for us. Because when we are discussing, it is not like that, as you rightly stated, that we are facilitating. But in the way of that facilitation process, we are also learning from them.
Absolutely. And because actually, another very important, advantage, it's not unethical to say, but I'll tell you the fact. When you do case study in the classroom, what I suggest, you keep your fit band and all, you see how many calories you burn when you take normal lecture. And you try to do case study and see how many calories you burnt after the lecture, you find the difference. In case study, in teaching, what will happen, regular teaching, we keep on speak, we keep on discussing, and students only listen. And your energy level absolutely goes down. After the lecture, you see how much burner calorie you must be burnt, how much tired you are after your lectures. You try to do case study and see after your lecture, you find much more relaxed. Your stress also will be relatively reduced. And at the end of the day, students will give feedback. If you do more case studies, you will get much more better response than regular classroom because you make students to discuss.
May I talk something?
Yes, madam. Pushpa, ma'am. Yes, please. Request everybody to speak.
Actually,
everybody's faculty.
Actually, whatever my understanding through case teaching and all this thing, like we do have course outcomes, is it? Like Bloom's taxonomy, we use it, like remember, understand, analyze, apply, create. All those things we expect students to do, is it?
So yes.
What happens in actual case discussions, late few of the students speak because they are in a situation to analyze the case. But others, they start from remembering whatever has been said. Some of them in the position of understanding it. Like we can do very well with all these levels of taxonomy. That is my opinion, sir.
Madam, normally how do you do cases? For an example, Pushpa ma'am, how do you do cases in the classroom? I'll give you the
actually,
suggested one.
Yes, and also I want some input from you also, sir, because
I will definitely do that. That is what I'm here. I definitely do that. I don't do comfortably, but I can do the gist of it.
Yes, sir. Actually, what do I do? Because I teach strategic management, retail also. I felt very nice that you are from retail background. Definitely, I want to connect with you for studying and all these aspects of retail marketing. I tell you what I do. Exhibit these cases to be taken in the class. Like, those are exhibited in the
what
topic.
What is the source
section.
Of case? What type of case do you use, ma'am, in the classroom? Because I'll tell you, most of the faculty, right? I ask them, do you use case study? They say, sir, I give live case. Yesterday also, there is a newspaper came. I gave them live. I said, boss, giving a newspaper article is not a case. Right? Many people do mistake. It's ignorance. I don't blame it. I said, sir, I'm giving live case study from the newspaper. Yesterday, there is some case happened. So what are the source of case do you use? What type of cases do you discuss in a classroom?
I'll tell you one interesting example, sir. I teach PPM also, this principles and practices of management. You are the person to tell me whether it is wrong or right, okay? So what I did, I told them, like, search FAYOL's 14 principles in the topmost organizations. And through the videos of CEOs and their company profile, their work culture, search for the practices or principles which are getting used into these organizations and why they are successful.
Okay. Okay. So Henry Fayol's 14 principles, perspective management. That is a classic subject which is removed by most of the business schools because this is there in all the subjects. I still remember 2007 when I was in Somaya. I went to the director, they gave me subject POM to teach. I said, sir, I'm not going to teach, please leave it. The director said, no, Shini, you have to teach. This is the best subject. Outcome of the subject, I published 10 cases. I'll tell you why. Okay. The subject is, most I am removed the subject called perspective management, but you can build contemporary latest things in the subject. For example, change management, knowledge management. You can do anything in the subject. It is applicable. Yeah. But if you teach, still keep on entry file, Maslow's hierarchy, you may not bring reality what it is happening. Yeah. You may not be able to connect with it. There is a possibility.
Yeah.
But still, all the principles are relevant today. I'm not denying it. But today, organization has changed. But try to customize it. Okay. I still remember, how do you teach the case study in the classroom? Normally, anybody would like to add, how do you teach case study in the classroom? Anyone? What is the source of the case? Means what type of case?
About case studies which I teach, I take them from the, like, online books are there which provide some cases. Sometimes I take it from online if any material I do find which is in the line with concept.
Length of the case? The page length?
Not more than 4 pages rather.
Okay. See, that's what normally what happens. There are certain business schools as the thumb rule. They don't use less than Harvard and Ivy school case studies for the classroom teaching. But when you are starting as a beginner, nothing wrong. See, please, I always remember, nothing wrong. Instead of taking some newspaper reference or online books, my suggestion, I always teach the basic things, pluck the fruits which is closer to you. That is a thumb rule. That means, I still remember, if you are from particular location, we are all business school faculties. I'll tell you what are the major benefits of discussing case or writing case. There are multiple benefits as a faculty. As I told you, when you are teaching case study, your energy level will go down, your productivity improves, your health improves, your stress level reduces, right? These are all the things you can literally face it when you try to teach cases. That other benefits is, if you are a faculty, for example, Pushpa ma'am, where are you basically from?
Sir, I'm from Kolhapur itself, presently
Fantastic.
Working with...
Yeah. Okay. Which institute?
Currently, I'm working with Sanjay Ghodawat University, sir.
Fantastic. I don't know, that university, I came twice, did FDP there also.
Sir, you are Sanjay most welcome Ghodawat. Again, sir. I want to meet you.
I've already done that, okay. Right?
Yeah.
I give you one suggestion, ma'am. If you are from Kolhapur, all management faculty, that's what I used to say, pluck the fruits which is closer to you. If you are sitting in Kolhapur, don't write a case what happened in Walmart, Tesco and Jesco, don't bring to the classroom. Students may not able to connect. If you are from Kolhapur, people like us, we can't able to reach to those places. For an example, I'm giving example, how Kolhapur jaggery industry, jaggery is a business, how they are doing it. If you could be able to write 4 pages, original documents.
Yeah.
From your topic relevant to your business. Whatever subject you try to teach, try to relate.
Yeah.
And see how the examples will come. For example, I'm giving example. How Star Gutka, Panwala launching an aircraft, Star Airlines. Will it become survival? Yes, this is a classic case. Yes, every airline is bleeding. Jet Airways is lost. Entire aviation is getting, royally, they are not making money across the world. In India, some airline is making money. I'm giving example. How Star Airlines is started. That itself is the case. If you write four pages, will it become survival? That's it. Case study, you have to highlight the problem and leave it. And for example, what is the advantage? You are in Kolhapur, you are in Sanjay Ghodawat, you can able to get access of all the data. If you try teach this and try to publish it in local paper, don't try to publish it in Harvard. Nobody is going to appreciate. If nobody publishes, least bother, give it to Cyber or give it to Sanjay Ghodawat Journal, academic journal. If it's original, they will publish.
Definitely.
That itself is a real case. I'm giving a live example. Applicable to entire 114 participants. Try to take the case, and what is the advantage of it? Now, you are created the original content, you are an author.
Yes, sir.
When you are, see how your faculty also elevated by doing these case studies. You are not a teacher now, you became a case writer. when you are adding your portfolio, I still remember when sir is introducing myself, if you note it down, you have 9 different portfolios I have. I'm not an only academician. I'm a trainer. I'm a consultant. I'm a case writer. I'm an author. I'm a publisher. I think everybody in the crowd can do. Everybody's an academician.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Definitely, sir.
How do you get into this? Write a case. Case yeah. writing is very interesting. Write 4 pages. The topic Thank which you, is sir. Relevant. You will also, when you go to the classroom, you are an author. The comfort level of teaching will go much, much, much better.
Definitely,
instead of using somebody's case. The yeah. purpose of this workshop, after the workshop, even if you could able to write 3 pages, 4 pages, start with even 2 pages is okay. How to write, I'll tell you later. But what happens,
Thank you, sir.
The confidence of the faculty improves it. Please remember, every faculty in this classroom, your confidence level also will improve. For example, somebody asked the questions here, sir, please tell some sources for download the case studies. You get the IV. Even you go to Harvard Business School, the cases are free for academicians. 90% people doesn't tell you guys. I'm telling you honest. Even if you go to Harvard Business School, every case is $4 to $5. If you register as an academician, his entire stuff is free for academic purpose. You can't download for circulating. For you, understanding is free. I published more than 2-3 cases, which is listed now in the Harvard now. Right? So you get royalty also. Forget about that other benefits of writing a case. Right? When you write a case, you become a consultant. You can become a trainer. Right? There are multiple benefits of writing case. Your performance in your API, academic performance index, you get 5 points. By attending this workshop, you'll get 5 points. When you write case study, publishing in summary, you get 3 APIs. Almost you get 10 API by doing this program, boss. Please remember that. That is also important today. As an academician, we have some commitments. You have to write, you have to publish. Okay. So I hope I go to IV. Case setter is okay to start with that. You can go to all Harvard Business School, William Davidson, WI, and Hong Kong Business School. You can go anywhere in the Google and type, even that the Emerald cases are available for, you know, classroom teaching. Very good. Especially they come with the cases for, you know, developing economies like India and all. They are much more focused with Indian case studies. Right. So when you teach case study, the other benefits, as I told you, right, today we discuss about how students will benefit. We also discuss how faculty will benefit. Now I'll come to the question Pushpa asked, right? How do you discuss case study in the classroom? Normally what happened, we give cases 2 pages in the classroom. We'll ask the student and the case will have 2 normal standard questions, right? Now my suggestion, new year suggestion, agenda. You go to the classroom with the case. Everyone, you go to the classroom with the case, remove the questions and give the case study to the student. You ask the students, I don't want answer from you guys. You tell me what question can be asked through the case. Again, I'll repeat. Go to the classroom. If there is a case study, there are specific questions, remove the question. And you ask only the student, what question can be asked through this case? You can take 10 to 15 minutes on that. Your session will be 90 minutes. Almost you get a breathing time to energy. But students also happy. If you go with 2 questions and answers, students will exactly hit the answer, the question which is asked in the case. You ask how many questions can be asked. Students will give 15 questions and you select top 3. But remaining 12 questions, you will understand, wow. Even you may not thought of it, I'm telling you honestly. Then you will realize, wow, is there any more information in this case? Some questions may be irrelevant, leave it. But students more happy because you are not asking answer, right? You are asking only question to be asked. Normally we ask questions, students will give answer. You try this reverse approach because if you see any Harvard or Ivy cases, they don't come with question. Question normally comes in teaching notes. Right? Especially when you try to do case study in the classroom, my suggestion, write small case letter. Ideal discussion for MBA, master degree program, you give 4 to 6 pages so that you will have more content to discuss. Don't give one paragraph. I still remember many faculty used to give one paragraph, you know, small, short cases and try to discuss. It may not be effective. While you are discussing a case, I'll tell you what are the stages in the case studies. I'm giving a thumb rule. Not necessary you have to follow the same, but I can give you that how to discuss case study, which makes them more attentive, right? For an example, case studies are discussed in 5 different stages. Case studies are used in 5 different stages in classroom discussion. Then you'll ask, sir, what are the 5 stages? First stage, give the case study to the students in advance and they have to read it individually and write the small synopsis of the case. That means the first stage of the case, when they come to the classroom, everybody should read individually. When you start the classroom, allow them 5 minutes to read individual again, even though if you give case study 1 week in advance. See, your 90 minutes, how it is planned. Because classroom session is very, very important. How do you manage the classroom during the case study? All right. So once the students are studied or understood the case individually, not necessary whatever they understood be same with others. That's why the stage 2 comes. The case study has to be discussed within group. That means you have to make the students in a group. Allow them another 10-15 minutes to discuss within the group. Right? That is the second stage. Yes, Pushpa madam?
No, nothing, sir. Nothing.
Somebody raised the hands, that's what. Okay. So the first stage, case has to be dealt individually. Second, case has to be discussed within group. And third stage, the discussion. See, please remember, case not to be presented. Normally we do mistake in the classroom. We ask the group to present. Don't do that. In fact, there is a method how to make a group, how to make seating arrangements, how the discussion should happen, what are the things to be done during discussion, what are the things to be done each and every stage, what are the things not to be done every stage. Very detailed, elaborate process are there, right? While discussing individual, they are not supposed to discuss with group. While they are discussing in within group, they are not supposed to discuss other groups. When they are discussing other groups, they are not supposed to discuss within group. That is a third stage. The third discussion happened group to group. What is the fourth level? Group to group discussion happening. What is the fourth level? What is the fourth stage in the case? Any idea?
Meeting the points, rather conclusion.
There is conclusion later the stage comes. What happened? Fourth level, the faculty has to share their own experience and expertise to the students. Till 3 stages, students only discuss. The role of the faculty to lead the discussion among the individual students and groups. And fourth level, when the faculty discuss, their knowledge is much better because they have done the case many times. If they are author of the case, when I discuss case study in the classroom, I used to carry my own discussion, own case of mine, which I published with many cases. And obviously that inputs of the case is much better as a faculty, right? Till three stages, the faculty role is facilitator. Fourth stage, faculty has become expert opinion. What is the fifth stage then? Any idea? Very tough, but I want answer from anyone. There are 116 people are there. Anybody please? What is the fifth level? Anybody? Yes, Imani ma'am. Garima? Prakash? Hello? What is the fifth stage? No, not necessary. It should be SWAT and all. SWAT and all is done during the progress of the first and second. What is the fifth level? Any attempt?
Sir, opportunity identification.
These things can be done in third stage, ma'am. Nothing wrong. You can bring it in fourth stage also. Nothing wrong. What can be done in fifth level? If you really wanted to make interesting the case. Nobody does it. Very rarely people do. After I'm telling you, you will understand that what is the meaning of it. But very interesting. Students likes it a lot. The fifth level. That also helps your institute, students, faculty. All three people have the same problem, which can be addressed by doing this. What are the problem major business school get problem? Any idea? One of the major complaint all business school gets. Any idea? What is the problem business schools gets one complaint from the industry? Especially MBA. Pardon?
Sir, placements.
Okay, then. Placement
skill,
doesn't happen because of
the skill gap. Like
skill gap. Okay, then. 90% problem people says this is the problem with the business schools.
Sir, they can create any business model, hypothetical business model, on the basis of the gain knowledge.
Okay, that 90% problem we get most of the business schools is industry institute interface. Right? When you teach MBA program, we should have a corporate connect more. Then only you can able to teach better. Am I right or wrong? Industry institute interface. How you have a corporate linkages? Placement is a byproduct of that. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So how do you bridge the gap during by doing this case study? Any idea? Anybody can think and tell me. How do you bring industry institute interface by doing case studies in the class? Very simple.
So we can invite expert for so that they can get the feedback of the people who are into that life situation.
For an example, if that madam writes a case study about Sanjay Godawar, I'm giving example. On that last day discussion, you already done the discussion for one day. I'm telling you, normally when I discuss case study in the classroom, it takes 3 to 6 hours. Very, very difficult to complete the case on time. But because of restriction of the institute, I have to complete on schedule. I'll give you very interesting. When you are discussing the case on the final day, after your discussion, faculty, multiple stages, if you could able to call, I'm giving a hypothetical case example. If you are rightly discussing a case about Sanjay Godawat, example, you have a proximity, you are also in Kolhapur. You can invite that Godawat, somebody's top senior, to come for the discussion on the final day. In fact, they love to listen from the business school students what is happening. Students also happy to learn from the industry practitioners. And you'll also able to connect it, right? That industry institute interface. And students feel, as a faculty, you also get your interaction with the corporate. If you are discussing case study about Yes Bank, I'm giving example. You write a case study about Yes Bank or PMC Bank. Now these are all problem, right? Problematic PMC Bank, if you are teaching finance or corporate governance or ethics or whatever issue, whatever subject you teach, you write a case study about and try to discuss in the classroom. You call nearby bank manager. Sir, we are discussing this case. Can you come and judge or can you give your expert opinion? Students are happy to listen to that. And you are also going out of the way. And even in your NAC also, you'll get more credits. See how many benefits you have. And when sir introducing me writing a case study book, trust me, that is not my book at all. There are 34 participants who attended my FDP, they have written the case. 40 people attended FDP, 35 people contributed case, 5 rejected. And how the institute benefited, we published a book. How faculty benefited, I published a book. How institute is benefited, they done a FDP. They did a MDP, revenue generation, plus book publication, industry interaction, wow. Can you believe everything can be done by doing just one case study? Why don't you make an attempt? The 5 stages, what I said today. You connect me on my LinkedIn, I'll help you how to do that. And don't try to bring faculty or don't try to bring the expert from outside. Nobody comes to you. Please remember. If you are from Pune, I still remember when I was writing my case, Chitle Bandhu case study in 2009. I used to visit first time to Pune during that time for symbiosis to teach. When I went to the store, I was amazing. People asked me to stand in queue to buy. I was started a retail program Somaya that time, 2005. First time in Western India, started MBA in retail management. Chitlis used to give, you know the Chitli, right? If you are from Pune, everybody knows it, right? The sweet shop in Pune. They sell Pakarwadi. And when you enter the store, they give some smart card to buy. Even today, it is not there in Shoppers Stop. They have done 11 years before. Something unique. I developed the case, I have written it. And published in Smart Manager. Go to Google and try. Dr. Srinivasan, Senior Srinivasan, Smart Manager, Sweet Salvation. You will find the case even now. The case solved by some American professor. Unexplored. Like that, you will find hundreds of examples. And don't try to quote and download the case which you are not comfortable. As a faculty, please remember the thumb rule of discussing case. You try to take the case which you have a comfort level. When I say comfort level, you should know how to deal the case properly in the classroom. When students ask some question, you can't say, I will tell you later. You should have a ready-made answer with you. Very, very important. That shows your confidence in the class. That shows how practical are you in the class, right? And whenever you do the case, somebody, Nikita ma'am said, role play of the case. This himself is the role play. You are bringing industry practitioners and try to do it in a classroom. What else do you require for 90 minutes or 3 hour session? We are not able to change the world. Please remember, I always used to say, faculties, we are just academicians. Our role is not change the world. We realize that right after marriage, even we don't have a right to change channels in front of the kids in television, right? That is the reality. So when you go to the classroom, don't say, no, I'm going to change the entire world. No, at least during my lecture, I can able to bring focused on the subject what we discuss. If you have a limited objectives, students will exit. It's a reality. I'm talking about the practical. Go to the classroom with a limited objectives, focused objective, and go through the case with the objective of what are you planning. Because case studies are absolutely objective in nature. Don't take the case corporate governance to marketing. If you are teaching corporate governance CSR, do the case. For example, as I told you, right? You write a case. Hundreds of cases are available now. IKEA has entered. This became success. It's a classic case. You try to discuss in the classroom. Will they become survival? All private nationalized banks are merged. Make in India is going to be the classic case. And impact of GST on the particular businesses, MSMEs. You can try to discuss, and students likes it a lot because they want to know what is happening. And you can able to connect with the subject relevant to market dynamics. Any questions? Hope I am on the track. Any questions would you like to ask? Hello? Hello?
Yes, dear participant, you are requested to raise your questions.
Any questions, any doubts? Because I can keep on discussing it. That's what I said, right? I don't have PPT or anything. Mujhe 6 ghante bhi aaram se baat kar sakta hu har topic ke upar. Do you have any doubts?
Sir, there is one question. Can you just make a focus on that hypothetical case study, sir?
Right. Wonderful question. Right. See, when you go to the classroom, original cases add value. Remember that. For example, Kiran Kakade is a lawyer. He said, sir, he teaches law. Example I'm giving. If something happened today to any ladies, we always try to quote Nirbhaya as a case. Am I right? Anybody can question Nirbhaya? It is a happened. It is a real incident. There is a verdict. There is a legal case happened for many years. But we don't stop only with Nirbhaya. Afterwards, there is a case happened in Mumbai on the compound, you know, old mill compound. Now you are discussing what is the problem today. We try to quote which is happened past all original cases. But there is a possibility, if you want to discuss sometime, the cases can be hypothetical in nature. Hypothetical means assumption. You know why? Sometimes company doesn't allow you to discuss the original. I'll tell you the other example. You go to Google right now and search it out simultaneously. Sweet Salvation by Dr. Srini or Srinivasan. Smart Manager case. When I was writing the case, I have a video film. I met Krishna Kedarina Chitle. In 2009, I took a video film. Amazing gentleman. I impressed the way they run a store. They are not only in sweets, they are in dairy. they are in IT, they are in infrastructure, 500 crore business that time. But I said, sir, I have written a case. Can you give permission to publish? They said, sorry, sir, we are conservative business family, run by family run, professionally family run business. We don't give any permission to publish this. Kiran, it happened, huh? After putting all the efforts, they give video film also. We took interview, but they said, we don't give any permission to publish it anywhere. Please excuse us. You asked for permission, I'm ready to apply. Then I sent case to, I'll tell you what is hypothetical case. I'll come to your question. I have done genuine work. Original case is written. I've sent it to Smart Manager. There is a magazine called Smart Manager, which goes to corporate CEO's table. That magazine that time was run by Geeta Piramal. She is also ex-Harvard and Piramal ma'am, you know, Geeta Piramal ma'am. And I've sent a case. They said, she needs a wonderful case. What to do now? I don't know whether to get published or not. Then the case got published in Smart Manager. I got surprised. But they mentioned Pendlekar Sweets. Pendlekar Sweets. There is no sweet shop in Pune called Pendlekar Sweets. We removed the word Chitle completely. If you want to buy Chivda, nobody goes to Chitle to buy Chivda, right? There is a Lakshmi Narayan Chivda shop, same store. Same line, there is a different store. That's why the sweet shop differentiate. If you want Pakarwadi, Chitle. How they make Pakarwadi? They imported the chocolate machine and made it. In chocolate machine, they imported from Swiss, they made a Pakarwadi in mass production. Normally, it is a conventional thought, but this Chitle did everything different. Normal sweet shop will attract 3 to 5 kilometers distance sales, but this sweet shop, whoever goes to US, even people travel 50 kilometers to buy Chitle Pakarwadi to take to US. Very amazing store. After writing this case, I have to remove and mask the original. That became hypothetical. But the problem is, local journal magazine may publish hypothetical case. But if you want to have a standard globally recognition, it should be original case. I'll tell you what happened to me last month when I was writing a case. I was mentioning about Jio case, right? Facebook investing in Jio. It took almost 6 months to write a case. After writing a case, we went to Reliance to get publication. Touchwood, I have good access with them. And to took approval, it took months time. But trust me, I will say only one thing. Unless and if we don't get approval, we don't publish. But all data, we took it from secondary, which is authentic, including Reliance video film, which is available on the shareholders annual meeting of Mukesh Ambani ji. There, he talked about 2 minutes about Jio, Facebook, that particular investments. Everything available in public domain. But they said, no, if we want to publish, get approval. Now I can't say real, Jio into BO and write a case. Nobody will appreciate. Maybe local journal might have publication, but I won't get global recognition. So what we have done, we approached Reliance, waited for a month, we took approval. That case can't be hypothetical, but you can discuss in the classroom hypothetical removing the name. But what is the value addition? If you want to teach original, when you put genuine effort, the case should be real, not hypothetical. Assumption-based case studies sometimes might be good for classroom teaching because every concept may not be bring into the classroom original, right? Because of the confidential, sometimes company doesn't want to disclose. I can also discuss, unfortunately, this lecture is recorded, right? So otherwise I can discuss many of the content. If the lecture is not recorded, I can give hundreds of examples on this, right? Any other questions? Hope I answered your answer, Kiran sir, Kakade.
Yes, sir. Thank you a lot.
Yeah, any other questions, please? So we have discussed finally, I'll give the summary of what we have done. We discuss about what is case. Cases are real life situation. There is a problem. There is a solution to that. And students, when you are discussing case study, is a pedagogy. We try to teach case study. Yeah. Okay. Somebody wanted to know about teaching notes. I'll come back to this. Yeah. That is a different topic, but I'll try to cover. Yeah. Right. So I'll just give the conclusion what we have done. It is always good to give summary of the session. End of the session is always good. Right. It's a small recap. Case studies are real life situation. When students discuss a case study in the classroom, they become protagonist. Right. There is a pedagogy. Teaching case study is a pedagogy. And students, everybody wish to learn the case because they are learning by doing, learning from others' experience. That is the major benefits of discussing case study. There is no time cost involved in the case, literally. Yes, if you buy the case from Ivy or Harvard, you have to pay in dollars. But still, we collect fees from the students. So I'm not talking about that cost and time. We are discussing about the problem solution for the case. There is no time and cost involved. The other benefits, it helps you to lead discussion, good leadership skill, communication skill, listening skill, and also helps you to develop group dynamics in the class. As a faculty, how you benefit? As I told you, the benefit of discussing case study, you can able to learn from the students. Your role of the faculty is facilitator, and your energy level is relatively reduced. When you try to teach case studies, your knowledge with the students' interaction goes much better. When you write a case and go to the classroom, improves the confidence, not only to the student, also with the faculties. Yes, right? And teaching case study is not absolutely new. In fact, I really appreciate the answer coming from John. Case study pedagogy is there in our historical Veda as well as Bhagavad Gita. Even if you see all the Vedic classroom teaching, if you see, yesterday I was listening. In fact, I'm very happy Professor John has highlighted something. In fact, I'm going to write a book on Indian business history. You know, it is going to be implemented in all the business school and soon as a new education policy. Anyway, that's a different topic I don't want to get into. And storytelling is the classic example of teaching pedagogy. And today UK is coming up with a new teaching pedagogy style. Today's morning news, they are coming with outside classroom teaching. They are going to come with outside classroom to teach. They said no class lectures now. It should be an open garden, open place. Trust me, this is what Indian education is all about. Guru Shishya Parampara, everything is world is following our Indian methods, which is proven record, which is true. Panchatantra is a purely storytelling. It's also purely on case based. Unfortunately, we don't do document. I'm sure we make an attempt. Even if you pluck the fruits, which is closer to you, write 2 pages short note case. You reach me on my LinkedIn profile. And I know every institute is original case studies are agreed to publish. I still remember Kale sir from Cyber. He published my own case, which I written about Air India disinvestment 2 years before he published the case. We are discussing today, right? So take real life situation, go to the classroom. You will also benefit. Students also will benefit. And as I told you, right, case studies can be discussed in multiple level. Not necessarily you have to follow all the 5 stage. You can use 2D method or 3D method or combination. But don't allow the student to present the case. Allow the student to discuss the case. And don't teach to the classroom. Be a facilitator. End of the day, we got a designation as a teacher outside classroom. That is sufficient. Inside the classroom, we became facilitator. Allow students to speak. Allow the students mobile to use. Nothing wrong. When I go to classroom, I tell them, please keep your mobile on. And the question, whatever I ask, they don't know. They have to search through Google. That is an option. Use the technology better. Yes, regarding teaching notes itself is sufficient to discuss one more session, but just giving a gist. Teaching notes is not meant for students, it is meant for faculties. When I write a case, we also give teaching notes to the faculty. Otherwise, faculty write something with the objectives. In teaching notes, first thing we'll have a synopsis, objectives, questions for practice, reading material, reference material, what concept are you going to teach through the case, your application part, what happened at the end. This minimum 8 to 10 contents should be there in the teaching notes. And because, as I told you, right, case may not have a question, but teacher should have the question, right? What are you going to discuss? So that if the faculty knows, they can able to discuss it better with the students. I can discuss more, but I can share some material on teaching notes. How to teach case study himself is required 6 hours in the classroom. how to teach case study in the classroom? How do you lead the discussion? How do you ask the question? How do you make the groups? It's a fantastic topics are available. I think we are come to the session to the end. I always have option, right? I always start lecture late because that is not in my hand, but I can complete lecture on time. That is in my hand.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Any questions are appreciated from the participants. Then I can give conclusion remark. Any questions?
I think, sir, most of the questions have already been practically with the live example through your session you have given. So I think most of the questions are solved, but still if there are, all the participants, they can put it forward.
I think I answered all the questions which is there in the chat box. What is BPL, problem-based learning? See, case study and BPL is absolutely different. Problem-based learning is a learning process. Case study is a pedagogy. Yeah, Nagalakshmi. Okay, and I wish all the best. Belated New Year wishes to all. I'm sure Cyber Institute is doing wonderful effort to bringing the best. Got opportunity able to listen earlier session also, right? If time permits, we can meet everyone. In fact, this is, as I told you, right, this is my first FDP on this year. Last year during COVID, I had done more than 7 to 8 FDPs on case writing, right? So I wish you all the best. Connect me in my LinkedIn profile. Whatever doubts you have, please connect me on my LinkedIn and wish to interact more. And start writing small caselets from your locality, wherever you are from. That is the way you should start. Forget about the quality. Quality will come. That initiation should be started first.
Yes, sir.
So we'll call it as a day. All the best. Wishing you everyone good luck and wonderful session. Thanks, college sir, for inviting me for this session, and the coordinator also, wonderful coordination work you are doing.
Yeah, just a moment.
Pleasure of meeting you.
Yes, sir. Just a moment, sir. Officially, we would like to give a formal vote of thanks. So indeed, I can just experience that along with you in this online FDP program on student-centered teaching learning methods in higher education. All of us have enjoyed a wonderful journey of 1.5 hours about the kind of the knowledge that you have been shared, and I hope that you have given a new knowledge, new attitude to all the teachers, the important teaching pedagogy about the case study, all the myths and facts you have already been covered, and a very important thing is that you have connected with all the participants, sir. So in today's world of this science and technology, the connect was missing. So I hope the human touch has been given by your session, and all the participants right from the beginning, the kind of the free flow of thoughts and question and interaction that they have given for this session, and the sir has given a very well justice to all the question. So on behalf of Atal Academy, on behalf of Cyber, we really appreciate, sir, that in your very busy schedule, that you are very busy with one of the Open Defense Viva, but still you could able to manage and given us such a wonderful sessions to all the participants. And very important thing is that for all the teacher, the upcoming management faculties, the kind of a takeaway message that you gave, the new knowledge about the case study, the new teaching pedagogy about the case studies, and the three important principles that the teacher should always able to have in his mind about teaching, about unlearn things up to the students, exploring the unexplored things, and the practicing the new thing. So these three principles will be really a takeaway message for all the participants, and I hope that all the participants will be able to soon publish their case studies in days to come. So they will definitely remember you, sir, that you have given and such a wonderful insight and such a great talk to all the participants. So on bottom of my heart, as well as the participants' feeling, I wish to communicate, and we hope that all will be connect to you through online, through LinkedIn and Gmail. So we appreciate your efforts, and from on behalf of Cyber and Atal Academy, I once again I thanks, and I conclude that this particular session is over, and as per the next sessions will be begin as per schedule around 2:30 p.m. So I once again thanks all the participants and the today's guest speaker, Dr. Srinivasan Iyengar sir. Thank you for joining this session. Signing out from Cyber.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.